And welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Splinter Cell Blacklist. I'm your host, that guy. Let's get cracking. We're here with Kobin. Although, Kobin's a bit of a dick. So, trying to help him get the hell out of here. Which I do not imagine being very easy right now. But still, there's quite a few different tactics you can use between smoke grenades, you know, all the general kind of games you can play with enemies, but I'm just going to try and make it through. See if we can plug as many people as we can without people getting too many, came too much. The main problem is we've only got a handful of shots left. Oh no. So he doesn't care, so that's alright. Heard sound from our left just then, but don't know whether to believe it or not. Just checking for any kind of movement. I haven't actually done this completely silently before, so might actually be my first time right now. Come on, there we go. Jesus.
Briggs, we're at the extraction. Where are you?
Spilling around. Cross street,
just
got blocked.
Stay.
This is slightly a painful part. Actually, it's not even slightly painful. It is painful. Because you gotta fight them all off, and you only have whatever toys you have right now. So, yeah.
Don't let him shoot me!
Just stay down.
Just be liberal with your equipment. Because you're gonna need it. Not kidding. Not kidding!
Really?
Shit. I'm not kidding. It's
worry about not getting
pretty heavy in this area. Very heavy. Come on.
Watch it, Fisher!
The main problem is that take on so many people simultaneously, so there's not many choices in it.
Somebody talk to me!
Just kind of clear that out a bit.
What kind of protector are you?
You want to go back in that cell?
Sure.
Excuse me.
In position.
Roger that.
Still got one more. Where is he? Come on. Show yourself. Guess we could just probably pick him up. Oh! Wrong person. Never mind. Alright, we gotta go hunting for him now. Oh, that's for you, buddy. Can't see it, so it doesn't exactly work. There we go. I gotta say, this is probably my worst gaming that I've done in a while, but get that off there so I can actually get a clean shot. Come on, where is he? One guy left. You want me to take him out? I'll take him out. Just to show him. You're not gonna show him at all, are you? Let's just.
Someone is here. Everyone, on alert.
Hello. There we go.
Sister, let's go.
Sorry about that, everyone. Don't know why he was stuck there, but I gotta admit, that's kind of weird of him.
Are you kidding me? I'm not even wearing shoes.
Move.
He's not wearing shoes.
The hell, man?
Grab on.
What? Why?
Do it.
Come on. Get away.
Whee!
Oh, that looks very slow.
Brakes, we're inbound now.
I don't know where he got that handlebar from, but still. Sam Fisher goes biking in his off time. Alrighty, so this is a quick explanation. Ghost doll, yeah, it makes more sense. Just go and try not to kill people, as opposed to, well, going out mindlessly killing people, I guess.
Wire transfer just cleared.
But, yeah, usually I end up with most points in Panther, but Ghost doll is definitely doable once you get later equipment. Trust me, it's actually quite easy. It's kind of scary how easy they make it, actually, because they give you a drone, and yep, when you have the word drone and knocking out people, because the only thing it fires is taser shots. Yeah. Kind of cheating.
Talk.
Okay.
Alright. 6 weeks ago, a client contacted me. He wanted small arms, Katyushas, a fucking missile launcher, you name it. He was willing to pay top dollar. Two. It was a good deal. It was too good.
You supplied weapons for Blacklist Zero?
Hey, I supply a lot of people, okay? They don't usually go around targeting U.S. bases.
Was it?
All I know is that they were talking about the attack on the embassy in Vienna, like they were fucking proud of it.
Hundreds of innocent people died in that attack.
Yeah, no shit! That's what I'm saying! This guy is a monster. He's a fucking ghoul, okay? And he doesn't leave loose ends.
Yikes. Shitty week, am I right?
This guy.
Ugh. What?
Who the fuck is this guy?
So you turned yourself in for protection.
Keep you idiots from killing me over Guam, yeah.
Briggs, how do you feel about storing our new cargo?
My pleasure.
What does that mean?
Grim, you and Charlie try and dig up any information you can about Kobin's mystery customer. It's time to go hunting.
Okay, so that's the safe house completed. Next stage is the... Well, they want us to... Really? We have to upgrade it?
How bad is a blowback from Benghazi?
We need to upgrade it.
We have to promise to bring Kobin back in one piece when we're done.
Is it useful?
He's strung out, pissed off, and a major pain in the ass. But I think he's got some intel we can use.
Keep me posted.
By the way, Sam, let me know if you want me to upgrade the plane. There's a lot of room for improvements around here.
Okay. Let's upgrade it. Radar shown in HUD. That's pretty good. Prototype SMG. No, that's not useful. Dead drop locations. That's always good. Faster regeneration. Unlock a custom loadout slot. 7 new weapons and customized gear in the field. So. They're actually all quite useful. $1,000 though, I'll buy it. Jesus. And 7 black market weapons. Now, the problem is that they're all set, so not really useful. But being able to change gear, not that useful either. Which I think that's all we kind of need. There is level 2 abilities for all of them as well, so can get whichever ones you want, but right now I just want to actually buy gear. I don't actually want to buy upgrades. Kobin says it's urgent you meet with him about the dirty bomb sighting in Kazakhstan. Who gives a shit? Tough luck. Not a chance. Maybe some other time. Is what I'm trying to say. But come on. Let's get going. Come on. Yeah, this is installed and the loading time is still insane. Because it loads everything up simultaneously, which is kind of annoying. Okay. Let's just go for it, huh? We know where it is, so... There we go. Oh, in case you're wondering, these other stages. These are the stages that they tell you. So Charlie sends you to there. Briggs wants you to get there. Yeah. It's a little crazy. Get two more takedowns on enemies investigating a disturbance. That's actually a lot easier than you think. Follow trail of Kobin's weapons and strike at the engineer's base. We can do that.
You know, I was asleep. You ever hear the Geneva Convention? I got rights, you know.
Look, I'll tell you what. If you can find a payphone, I'll let you call your lawyer.
Did you get anywhere with the recon?
I'm still trying to build a workaround to grab a fee. Just give me 2 minutes. Sorry to interrupt. The president's office confirms 3 dev crew teams are prepped and standing by.
Thanks, Ollie. Make sure they're ready on our go.
You know what? Just give me this. That's where the cash dropped into my account. It was a wire transfer.
You guys have any updates on that potential 4th location?
We're just completing the trace now. Looks like the transfer came from Mirwawa, eastern Iraq. Grim, I'm not getting any images.
It's okay, I've got it. You just pull Onyx satellite time from the NRO. Looks like the largest of the 4 camps we've found. Heavily fortified.
Listen up. Our best bet for Kobin's buyer is Mirwawa. I want to be on the ground an hour ago. Charlie, check the satellite feed, map every weapon, vehicle, and man in that camp. There's a kid with a cap gun I want to know about.
Will do.
Briggs, prep a drone for overwatch.
On it.
Grim, coordinate with dev crew. We're gonna have to hit the other sites when we move on Mirwawa.
We don't have enough time to prep, Sam.
Oh, we're prepped now.
I need to be on the ground as soon as we're over the camp.
You're going in alone?
Yeah. Sorry. Sorry about skipping that.
Sticky cams will help with situation awareness while keeping bad guys off balance.
Sticky EMP's not that useful. Tri-Rose is a cheating weapon, as I said earlier. But what we want is sleeping gas, which is always good. Proxy shocker isn't too bad either. But we're also going to have to buy some other items. Frag grenade. Yeah, I'm a fan of it. What we want is incendiary, so we're all quite useful. And then we're going to have to start upgrading the goggles as well. Basically, each of them goes on top of each other. Some of them are good, some of them are absolute crap. But by the end of it, you kind of understand what you're getting yourself into. So it's all about trying to choose the best thing. Okay, what I need is... probably too expensive. actually, here's a fort. If I get the G36, a silencer. Does it take a silencer? Yep. Wouldn't even have to worry about it. There we go. Hollow sight, ACOG sight. There we go. It's perfect as well. And... yeah, you can only choose a certain amount of different abilities, but still, like, quite good. Just trying to choose the stuff that's obviously better. Some stuff you'll identify as really good, and other stuff is absolute garbage. So, weapon consistency, don't really need control. You can only have one of them anyway. That'll do. Special weapon, you want the crossbow. I'm not going to kid around. Basically, it allows you to have sleep gas and stunning and kill abilities. So, kind of a mix of all 3 weapon types. Plus it's stealth. So, pretty darn good. That will be your ghost abilities, basically. Another very long loading screen, which I absolutely hate. Follow the trail of Kobin's weapons to strike at the engineer's base of operations. At the top of the screen, usually they show, like, things you can do, but at the same time, usually hints to other things.
Break, can you hit the hostiles with no witnesses? Clearing your approach.
Okay, so what we are, we're Briggs right now. We got a sniper rifle. Let's try to take out as many as you can. Gotta admit though, you're supposed to do this without being sighted, so...
Sam, they know you're there.
Oops.
Camp's in lockdown. Mission scrubbed.
There's a particular order that you're supposed to do this in, so... just can't remember what the hell order it is.
deployed. Briggs, can you hit the hostiles with no witnesses?
Clearing your approach. Target eliminated. He's down. He's gone. He's down.
Okay.
I got him. Hostiles down.
Sam, they are there.
Well, I think you get the idea. I'm going to just try one more time, but we're over time anyway, but let's give it one more shot, huh?
Bastards deployed. Briggs, can you hit the hostiles with no witnesses?
Clearing your approach.
Oops, missed that one.
Sam, they know you're there. You're in lockdown.
Okay, maybe one more shot. you get the idea, though. Just take out all, what, 8 of them, and that's it.
Bastards deployed. Briggs, can you hit the hostiles with no witnesses?
Clearing your approach.
I'm not really too sure what kind of weapon actually makes that kind of sound. It's kind of weird.
He's gone. He's down. Hostiles down.
Oops.
Sam,
anyway, yeah, that's pretty much how you do it anyway. I'll start the next episode with all of them already dead, okay? So, let's finish up here. So, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And as per usual, take care of yourselves out there, yeah?